I always like it when a couple chooses for their first reading that passage from Genesis, which gets right back to the root of things, the creation account, reminding us that marriage and family life are not something that you and I have invented somewhere along the line, not some sociological construct, but rather something from the mind and heart of the Creator, a way of living. A way of living that finds in two people a kind of companionship and friendship that is life-giving and can bring them safely home to their destiny of eternal life. The two of them go together for us here at St. Rita's. They're a reminder that we have certain weaknesses that are inborn to us, and they're a reminder that we have the gift of grace and the promise of a future in God. These two things are what you give and accept to and from each other in your marriage vows. The ordinariness of human nature, although you look at each other and you see more than ordinary, you see lovability, you see things that you cherish already, things that will only deepen in time and grow. But you also see in each other the promise of God's faithfulness. Otherwise, you'd be maybe at the beach or in the Caribbean or something, doing this somewhere else. You're here. You're here in a house of God, which is steeped in tradition, which is tied to the generations of family, and which gives us all a sense of the providence of God in which you trust, and through which you make your profession of vows.
Be my wife.
I promise to remain faithful to you.
I promise to remain faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you. All the days of my life.
I, Sharon Gata.
Take you, Adam James Russell.
Take you, Adam James Russell. Be my husband.
I promise to remain faithful to you.
I promise to remain faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
Sharon, take this ring.
And receive it as a sign of my love.
And receive it as a sign of my love.
And of my faithfulness.
And of my faithfulness.
In the name of the Father and of the Son.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Adam, take this ring.
And receive it as a sign of my love.
And receive it as a sign of my love.
And of my faithfulness.
And of my faithfulness.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father, and the Son.
And
of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Very fun, smart, beautiful, and caring person. I have always been proud to call her my sister and more importantly, my best friend. She is also a very beloved aunt. My girls absolutely adore Sharon. Even my dog Gabby has a special love for her Aunt Sharon. When Sharon met Adam, she told me about him right away. But she headed out for a girls' night, and Adam, who recently started driving for Lyft, also known as Uber for anybody not in the know, and he had been their driver. Sharon was lucky enough to sit in the front seat for the ride that gave Sharon and Adam the opportunity to meet. The conversation went so well that after the ride, Adam reached out to one of the girls he went to high school with, that Sharon was with, to get her number. Adam had shared this is not something he would typically do, but felt that he had to do it. It was clear they both had experienced that something special, which led them to their first date the following night at Brett and Anna's. I love that you make my sister the happiest she has ever been. All jokes aside, Adam is a great guy. He is a hard worker, smart, caring, and thoughtful gentleman. Adam, I'm happy to call you my brother. Even if some of our happier moments happen to happen in Ohio, the road ahead of you may be unknown. But knowing that whatever lies ahead, you can handle, because Adam will be there for you, Sharon. And Sharon, you'll be there for Adam. And you'll be together as a team always. Even if it's higher. Remember, as a team, you should be there for each other always. To love, listen, give advice, support, laugh, keep each other in check, have each other's back, and of course have fun.
All jokes aside, these are two of the most wonderful people and wonderful couple I've had the opportunity to meet, and they've truly become family to Anna and I. And as Adanya mentioned, we've spent a lot of countless weekends together showing Sharon the more benefits and recreational things to Ohio, such as drinking. But in all seriousness, I've never met a couple more devoted to the contentment of their family and friends as these two. And it speaks ages about both of them. They truly cherish faith, family, and friends. I love you guys. And so sure enough, to Adam's surprise, as the beautiful woman sitting next to him, sat in the passenger seat next to him, and instantly hit it off the entire car ride. To the extent that, from what I recall Sharon telling me, her friends had to break her concentration from Adam when they arrived at the venue. They're like, hey, it's been 10 minutes. Are we doing this or are we leaving you here all night? But I could instantly tell when I met her Philly charm, like, he found the one. I'm scared of her. So I've never met a more stronger, independent woman, more loving than Sharon.